honestly, I mean, the thing that people were like, are you sure? You know, there was like the you know, the fact that he's gay, I think, was just sort of, people were like, you know, are you sure you want to do so? And I was like, to me, that was the selling point. I think the fact that there's such a dynamic, complicated character in a movie like this was a huge sort of upside for me. So not just that, I mean, I think he's a very sort of complicated character in general, and the fact that I get to explore a character like that in a movie of this kind of magnitude was I was a no-brainer for me. I found out about this job. I was shooting something else, so I literally came straight from one to the other. So I think, thankfully, I didn't really have too much time to get into like how obsessed with the books the fans are. So I didn't really feel the pressure of that the rest of the cast had for years being attached and not, you know, having not started yet. So I just kind of rolled in and we just started filming. So,
Kevin, how does it feel? I mean, you're in the League of Shadowhunters and now you're in the League of Screaming Girls. How is this going with your career right now? Are you kind of overwhelmed? Are you like, let's do this?
I think I'm at a point in my life. I mean, I just got married last week.
Congratulations, by the way.
And I'm just happy, you know. This is all great. I mean, the fact that anyone goes to see any movie that I'm in is crazy to me. So I'm just kind of soaking it up.
The wardrobe has been amazing from this film.
Yeah. They're all. I wear this great vest that has the two sort of swords in the back of it. So, and it was the most comfortable thing. They made it all for us, so it was actually a lot more comfortable than it probably looked. So, yeah. All right. Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin.